Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand priority interrupt Desi chain mechanism. So the concept of priority interrupt has already been explained in our previous video. If you haven't watched that video, please watch that video. In the priority interrupts, one of the mechanism which implements the priority interrupts is Desi chain mechanism. In this class, we'll try to understand that mechanism. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concept. And the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Now coming to this class, so in the previous class what we have discussed is priority interrupts. The services for the priority interrupts can be provided in two different ways. One is software mechanism by using software and the other one is hardware. In the previous class we have also discussed about polling mechanism. So it is a software implemented a priority interrupt, and by using the hardware there are two different ways. One is serial connection and other one is parallel connection. Serial connection means all the input devices are connected serially to the CPU. Parallel connection means all the input devices are connected parallelly to the CPU. So that makes the differentiation. So the serial connection mechanism is what we call it as a Desi chain mechanism. Desi chain mechanism that we are going to understand in this class. So this is the hardware for the Desi chain mechanism. So how this hardware is looking like is that we will try to understand. So these are the devices, device 1, 2, 3. These devices are connected serially onto a single line. So onto this single line, the interrupts that are generated by these devices are connected serially to the CPU. So this is what this is how the Desi chain will look like. And the priority, high priority device, the chain starts from the high priority device and it moves on. So as it moves on, the devices will be of the lowest priority. So this is the highest priority, next priority, next priority, and the least priority is going to be far away from this, far away in the other end of this chain. So this is how the chain will be. And so what happens and how this mechanism will work, how this entire hardware circuit will work is, for example, if the device has something to transfer. So if the device is having something to transfer on to the CPU through which it will get the content will get stored onto the memory. So what happens is a device that is ready for the transfer of data will send an interrupt signal. So this interrupt line will be continuously generating a one signal. So signal one will get continuously, high signal will get generated continuously in this line. So whenever an interrupt is generated by the devices, an active low, so a low signal will be generated. So the low signal will get generated. So this is what we call it as negative logic, right? So a low signal will get generated. Whenever a low signal is generated at this point, is identified at this point, so the CPU knows that an interrupt has been generated. So now what the CPU will do is, in response, in order to provide the service to the device which has generated the IO, which has generated the interrupt, in order to provide the service, in response, the CPU will generate an interrupt acknowledgement. So the interrupt acknowledgement will be transferred. So the first device through which the interrupt acknowledgement will be passed on to is going to be the highest priority device. So highest priority device is connected as the first device to the chain, and as we move on, the last device is going to be the least priority device. So the interrupt acknowledgement that has been generated by the CPU will be received by the first device. If the interrupt is generated by this device, it will pass on to the priority in priority out. So the output is going to be priority out. So what this interrupt acknowledgement will be is, it is a 1. So whenever the interrupt priority in receives the 1, if the device has generated the interrupt signal, that device will take that signal, take that acknowledgement, and it will pass on 0 to the other device. So the next coming to the next device, it will pass on 1. If the interrupt that is generated is not done by this device, so it will just pass on the acknowledgement, which is 1. So if this is the device which has generated the interrupt signal, it will take this 1 and pass on 0 to the next device. It means that I am the highest priority device in the line which has generated the interrupt. So I am taking this interrupt acknowledgement and I am passing on, this device will pass on 0 to the next device, which means that I am going to take the processor time. So in response, after receiving the interrupt acknowledgement, what this device will do is, it will forward the vector address. The vector address will be forwarded to the CPU. So what is the vector address? The address at which the interrupt service routine programming is located. So this concept we have covered in the first introduction to the priority interrupt initiated IO. So in that video we have covered that. If you haven't watched that, please watch that. So this vector address, which is related to the interrupt service routine of this device, so that vector address will be passed on to the CPU. So now the CPU will start servicing the device in the priority basis. So based upon the priorities, the interrupts that are generated and based upon the priorities of the device, the CPU is going to service the interrupts. So that is how the daisy chain will work. Okay, so whenever, for example, after generating this signal, after providing services by the CPU to this device, if this device has generated the signal, so after transmitting the vector address, what the interrupt signal will do is, it will make this signal as 1. So this continuously produces a signal 1. Signal 1 means there are no pending devices that are to be serviced. Okay, so now the interrupt is ready to take. So this INT is ready to take the input. Now when we are providing service to this device, device 2 is being serviced by the CPU, and at that time, if this device has generated an interrupt, a low signal has been generated by this, so a low pulse will get generated, and when this, sorry, low pulse means this is this low pulse will get generated, and when this signal is received at this point, an interrupt acknowledgement will again generated. So the interrupt that is being executed by the CPU will stop, and now the interrupt acknowledgement will be generated and it will be passed on to the devices. Now as and when the interrupt acknowledgement is received here, one received here, so this device, so being the highest priority device, this device will take that 1 and it will pass on 0. So now the this address, vector address of this interrupt service routine for this device, the vector address of that interrupt service routine will be passed on to this CPU, and for this the service will start. And after completion of that, after providing the service to this device, again it will, so it has been stopped in at certain point, right? So first it started servicing this device, but within that this has been interrupted. So the CPU has been interrupted by this device. So now being the highest priority device, the CPU started servicing this device, and after completion of that device, after providing the complete service to that device, again the incomplete uh, interrupt the in, incomplete uh, part of this device service will get started. So this discussion, so this is how the daisy chain will work, and this is a serial connection, hardware interrupt service providing mechanism. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.